Hello students, welcome to the interactive English language training classroom. Training of English language in the four skills, that is LSRW, listening, speaking, reading
and writing.
Out of these four skills, two are the input skills and two are the output skills. ਇਨਪੁਟ ਸਕਿੱਲਸ ਉਹ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹੈ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਰਿਸੀਵ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਰਿਸੀਵ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਕਿ ਲਿਸਨਿੰਗ ਸੁਣੀ ਜਾਂਦੀ ਹੈ ਦੈਨ ਦ ਪਰਸਨ ਇਜ਼ ਏਬਲ ਟੂ ਸਪੀਕ ਸਿਮਿਲਰਲੀ ਰੀਡਿੰਗ ਇਜ਼ ਦਾ ਇਨਪੁਟ ਸਕਿੱਲ ਯੂ ਰੀਡ ਦੈਨ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਏਬਲ ਟੂ ਰਾਈਟ ਐਂਡ ਟੂਡੇ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਫੋਕਸ ਔਨ ਦ ਫਸਟ ਇਨਪੁਟ ਸਕਿੱਲ ਦੈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਲਿਸਨਿੰਗ ਸਕਿੱਲ ਸੋ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਦ ਲਿਸਨਿੰਗ ਸਕਿੱਲ ਕਲਾਸਰੂਮ ਟੂਡੇ ਲੈਟਸ ਡਿਸਕਸ the format and some important tips how to go about this test ਇਹ ਟੈਸਟ ਅੱਜ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਰਨਾ ਕਿਵੇਂ ਹੈ ਇਹਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ 'ਚ ਆਪਾਂ ਪਹਿਲਾਂ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਡਿਟੇਲ 'ਚ ਡਿਸਕਸ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ
ਦ ਟੈਸਟ ਫੋਰਮੈਟ ਇਜ ਇਟ ਰਿਕਾਰਡਿਡ ਟੇਪ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਪਲੇਡ ਵਾਂਸ ਓਨਲੀ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਟੈਸਟ ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਯੂਜਲੀ ਇਟ ਇਜ 30 ਮਿਨਟਸ ਬਟ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਨੋਟ ਗੋਇੰਗ ਟੂ ਡੂ ਦ ਫੋਰ ਸੈਕਸ਼ਨਸ with 10 questions each section but we will be doing two sections with 20 questions only the rest we'll do in the next session so today we will be explaining what is a listening test how we have to do it how we have to perform it and then you have to answer the questions it will be two sections separately and 10 questions each
so bachcho jo ma'am ne kiya hai there are four sections of every listening test to four section cho aaj assi sirf section 1 and section 2 tade naal discuss karange solve vi karange I hope all of you are carrying your copies and pencils us de vich tusi numbering kar leni hai 1 to 20 tusi inu apni apni copies de upar likh lo 1 to 20 because assi ek audio play karange jide vich 20 questions honge questions will be on the screen you will read the questions and write the answers
the things you have to be careful about are that it is usually a 40 item test and 40 marks so it will be 20 marks and 20 questions what you will have to perform today so the test format is first section will be a conversation between two persons in a social or a real life situation for example it can be a conversation about accommodation or shopping or travel arrangements or visiting a new city and visiting a new university campus
so these are the different examples
these are the examples yes
aur aaj apa jehdi audio play karange that will be two people discussing a trip which was taken by one ek dona cho ek jane ne koi trip liya hai and the other person will ask questions about that trip this is the introduction we are giving for today's audio
second section is usually a talk by one speaker based on social or real life situations like a tour guide news broadcast weather forecast a description of facilities or description of a historical building but what we will be doing is it will be a topic from the book that you are studying either a plus 1 topic or a plus 2 topic
so today's audio is based on a lesson from 10 plus 1 textbook so some tips for the listening test aaj da listening test kar diya hoya tusi kede kede gallan da dhyan rakhna hai while you are listening number 1 you have to be very attentive that is for sure your whole focus should be on the listening and please listen to any important name or a place or any important date there can be a mobile number or an address these are the important things you have to focus on kyunki na jo kise de upar you can be asked a question and listening test is a test of multitasking matlab tusi at a time multiple kaam kar rahe ho you are listening to the audio you are reading the questions on the screen and you will be writing the answers in your notebooks
simultaneously answering the
Answer these yes. three things will be simultaneous. ਇਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਆਡੀਓ ਸੁਣ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ ਕਿ ਚਲੋ ਮੈਂ ਬਾਅਦ 'ਚ ਆਂਸਰ ਲਿਖ ਲੈਂ. ਨਹੀਂ, ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਰਾਈਟ ਦ ਆਂਸਰ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਅਦਰਵਾਈਜ਼ ਯੂ ਵਿਲ ਮਿਸ ਦ ਨੈਕਸਟ ਆਂਸਰਸ. ਸੋ ਬੀ ਵੈਰੀ ਅਲਰਟ, ਬੀ ਵੈਰੀ ਫੋਕਸਡ ਐਂਡ ਕੰਸਨਟ੍ਰੇਟ ਔਨ ਦ ਆਡੀਓ.
ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਪੇ ਅਟੈਨਸ਼ਨ ਟੂ ਦ ਇੰਸਟਰਕਸ਼ਨਸ ਐਂਡ ਅੰਡਰਲਾਈਨ ਦ ਕੀ ਵਰਡਸ. ਤੁਸੀਂ ਨੋਟ ਕਰੋਗੇ, ਕੀ ਵਰਡਸ ਨੋਟ ਕਰੋਗੇ ਕਿ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕਿਹੜੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਪੁੱਛੀ ਜਾ ਸਕਦੀ ਹੈ. ਜਾਂ ਆਪਾਂ ਨੇ ਇਹ ਧਿਆਨ ਦੇਣਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਜੇ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਲਿਖਿਆ ਹੋਊਗਾ ਨੋ ਮੋਰ ਦੈਨ 3 ਵਰਡਸ, ਤਾਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਓਨੇ ਹੀ ਲਿਖਣੇ ਹੈ ਆਨਸਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ. ਆਲ ਵਰਡਸ ਆਰ ਕਾਊਂਟਡ. ਸੋ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਰਾਈਟਿੰਗ ਯੋਰ ਆਨਸਰਸ ਔਨ ਦ ਵਿਦ ਅ ਪੈਨਸਲ. ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਯੂਜ਼ ਅ ਪੈਨਸਲ. ਹੋ ਸਕਦਾ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਸਪੈਲਿੰਗਸ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਹੈਗੇ ਆ ਉਹ ਕਰੈਕਟ ਕਰਨੇ ਪੈਣ ਜਾਂ ਕੋਈ ਆਪਣਾ ਚੇਂਜ ਕਰਨੀ ਪਵੇ ਆਨਸਰਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ. ਸੋ ਯੂ ਹੈਵ ਟੂ ਰਾਈਟ ਵਿਦ ਅ ਪੈਨਸਲ, ਨਹੀਂ ਤਾਂ ਕਟਿੰਗ ਹੋ ਜਾਏਗੀ ਆਨਸਰ ਸ਼ੀਟ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ.
Very often the answers change, ma'am.
Haanji, very often.
So you can write with the pencil.
Don't hurry to write the question, the answers. Because ho sakda hai, oh, fir uddu baad keh de, sorry, no, it was not like this. So you have to change the answer at times. But listen carefully. Instructions da dhyan dena hai. Te instructions sunan to baad, agar asi listening kar de haan, ta then you will be able to attempt it in a better way.
And check your spellings also. Spellings are very important because wrong spellings are considered as a wrong answer. And listen to the instructions as ma'am just discussed. Audio play jado hoegi, a voice will be instructing you. Like for example, read question number 1 to 5 or read question number 6 to 10. Ta us time de which you are supposed to read the questions. When you are told ki check your answers, so you will go through your answers. So see apne answers check karoge. So idda diya audio instructions milangiya. If you are not attentive, you may miss the instructions. Or ek vari tusi agar lose karge pace, ta thoda mushkil ho jayega. So be very careful and listen to the instructions.
Be very focused and alert, as sometimes the answers come very fast, one after the other, and at times ਕਿੰਨਾ ਪੈਰਾਗ੍ਰਾਫ ਬੀਤ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਫਿਰ ਵੀ ਕੋਈ ਆਨਸਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਉਂਦਾ. ਡੋਂਟ ਗੈਟ ਨਰਵਸ. ਹੋ ਸਕਦਾ ਆਨਸਰ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਲਾਸਟ ਲਾਈਨਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੋਵੇ. ਸੋ ਜਸਟ ਵੇਟ ਐਂਡ ਲਿਸਨ ਟੂ ਦ ਆਡੀਓ. ਡੋਂਟ ਜੰਪ ਟੂ ਦ ਕੰਕਲੂਜਨ, ਐਸ ਵੈਰੀ ਆਫਨ ਦੇਰ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਚੇਂਜ ਇਨ ਦਾ ਆਨਸਰ ਔਰ ਓਪੀਨੀਅਨ. ਆਨਸਰ ਚੇਂਜ ਹੋ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ, ਉਹ ਸੌਰੀ ਕਹਿ ਕੇ ਆਨਸਰ ਬਦਲ ਵੀ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ, ਜਾਂ ਉਹਦੇ ਆਨਸਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਉਹਦੀ ਲਾਈਕਿੰਗ ਬਦਲ ਸਕਦੀ ਹੈ ਜਦੋਂ ਦੋ ਜਣੇ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਹੈ. So we have to be very clear and wait and listen and then answer the questions.
And if you miss an answer, don't lose the pace of the speaker by thinking about it. Leave it. Move on. You can come back to it later on. You see, ek din sochde hoye agar ruk gaye ta next 2 or 3 answers miss bhi ho sakte hai. And don't leave any blank spaces. Supposing you are given 5 questions and you missed one answer, you can guess from the context, thoda andaaza bhi laga ke likh sakde ho, because koi negative marking nahi hai. So these are some of the points which you have to be very careful. So are you ready now? Let's do this test and we'll play the audio from here. We'll display the questions on the screen. You will be given time to read the questions and then answers have to be written in your notebooks. Listening test. So we are going to start the audio now.
You will hear different recordings and you will have to answer the questions on what you hear. There will be time to read the instructions and questions and you will have a chance to check your work. The recording will be played once only. The test has 4 sections. At the end of the test, you will be given 10 minutes to transfer your answers to an answer sheet. Section 1. You will hear a conversation between 2 persons discussing about a trip to Anandpur Sahib. Before you listen to the audio, you have some time to look at questions 1 to 6.
Now listen to the audio and answer the questions.
Hi Khushpreet, I saw your pictures on social media yesterday. Where did you go? It seemed to be a wonderful place.
Oh, I went to Anandpur Sahib yesterday.
You went to Anandpur Sahib and came back on the same day? Isn't it in a remote location and very far away from Chandigarh?
No, not at all. It's approachable by rail as well as road. We can take a bus from the bus stand in Sector 43 Chandigarh and reach Anandpur Sahib in 2 hours. Alternately, we can take a taxi and reach in 1.5 hours.
Is there any good place to take a short tea break on the way?
Yes, there is the Haveli restaurant near Rupnagar. It's very neat and clean. They serve very tasty food and beverages too.
You must be feeling very peaceful after visiting the Takht Shri Keshgarh Sahib Gurdwara.
Oh yes, it was a great experience. We sat outside the hall and enjoyed the view of the hills as well as the sound of the hymns.
Did you visit any other Gurdwara there?
No, not this time. But soon I am going to plan another trip to visit the other Gurdwaras.
Oh great! Maybe we can plan a trip together. But I was wondering about the pictures you took in front of a building which did not look like a Gurdwara.
Oh, that was the highlight of my trip, the Virasat-e-Khalsa Museum of Sikh History.
I never knew that there is a museum in Anandpur Sahib. Where is it located exactly?
It's strange that you have never heard of the museum. It was inaugurated in November 2011. Since its opening, it has become the biggest tourist attraction, not only for the local residents, but for the foreigners as well. It's quite near the Takht Shri Keshgarh Sahib Gurdwara.
The building looks very large and impressive.
You have some time to check your answers. Before you listen to the rest of the audio, look at questions 7 to 10. Listen to the audio and answer the questions.
Indeed, it's very impressive. It was designed by Moshe Safdi.
Oh, how do you spell Moshe Safdi?
It's M-O-S-H-E-S-A-F-D-I-E. The Eastern Complex has clusters of galleries that are designed on the lines of the fortress architecture of the region, like that of the Takht Shri Keshgarh Sahib Gurdwara. The galleries are made in groups of five to reflect the five virtues of Sikhism, which are truth, compassion, contentment, humility, and love.
What is there inside the museum?
The museum beautifully unravels the Sikh heritage of more than 500 years in 27 glorious galleries. We get a glimpse of the teachings of all the Sikh gurus and the creation of the Khalsa Panth by the 10th Guru, Guru Gobind Singh Ji. There is a live account of the history of the Sikh religion from the 1st Guru to the 10th Guru.
Oh, I see. Must be great to learn about the Sikh religion which originated in Punjab and that too in the city where the Khalsa Panth was created.
Yes, that's wonderful and an enriching experience. Also, the museum doesn't tell about the history of the Sikh, but also presents the culture of Punjab. As one steps into the first gallery, standing on a walkway with a 360-degree view of the surrounding murals, one is taken through a nostalgic journey of an old village of Punjab from early dawn to dusk. Punjabi festivals and rituals are shown by play of light on the murals and are accompanied by Punjabi folk songs.
I always considered museums boring because I thought that all they have are items which are on display and can only be viewed. But your account of the Virasat-e-Khalsa Museum seems very interesting. I would surely visit it with my family.
This is the end of section 1. You have some time to check your answers.
So students, I hope you have solved all the questions. Do you want to check your answers? Okay, now we are going to display the answers on the screen. Please check your answers.
Number one, it was the 43 sector bus stand. The sector was in sector, the bus stand was in sector 43. And the next is what was it? It took 2 hours to reach Keshgarh Sahib. So what was on the way? Where was the restaurant? It was near Roopnagar. So how did the person feel on going to the Gurdwara, to going to Takht Keshgarh Sahib? He felt very peaceful. So there were three voices. You must have heard three voices. One voice was giving instructions. Then the girl voice was the person who had already visited the Gurdwara, and the person asking was a male voice. So you have to also be careful about the voices. Who said what? So the person was feeling very peaceful while visiting the Gurdwara. So fifth point is, what was that building in front of the Gurdwara? It was not looking like a Gurdwara. It was Virasat-e-Khalsa. So it wasn't a Gurdwara, but it was Virasat-e-Khalsa. So answer was, the pictures were taken in front of a building which did not look like a Gurdwara. So how big was the building?
It was very large
and impressive. Who had made that the
Virasat-e-Khalsa?
That was Moshe Safdi. You must have heard this word thrice. It was spelled Moshe Safdi. Then the person repeated it. So at times these things were repeated. What the answer is, it has to be repeated. It is repeated twice or maybe thrice so that you get the hang of it. You get the spellings. So next was, what is 500? What was the question? Number 8. The question is, next slide, ma'am. It is the heritage of more than 500 years in 27 galleries. So it was how many years? The scene at the Khalsa Museum, it overgoes for 500 years. The story unna ne 27 galleries de vich explain kiti hoi hai, the Sikh story. So the next is, the museum does not tell just about the history but also the culture of Sikhism. What is the culture in Punjab? What was the history of people of Punjab and Sikhs? So that has been explained. So here are the first 10 questions. We will be giving you the section 2nd now. And you have to answer questions
11 to 15
and then 16 to 20. So we will be careful. Write your numbers from 11 to 20. We will be playing the audio just now. You look at the questions. It is a topic from plus one class, and you will be able to answer the questions after listening to the audio.
So listen carefully and answer the question. Best of luck for the section 2.
It will be section a single two. Voice.
You will hear an account of the Armed Forces Museum given by a guide. Before you listen to the audio, you have some time to look at questions 11 to 15. Now, listen to the audio and answer the questions.
Welcome to the Armed Forces Museum dedicated to the recipients of the Paramveer Chakra. Paramveer Chakra is the highest gallantry award instituted by the Government of India to be conferred on those soldiers who display exemplary courage and bravery in their fight for the honor, dignity and the protection of their motherland. We can sleep in peace only because of the alert presence of these sentinels at the borders of our country. The recipients of this award laid down their lives but changed the course of the war through their great display of courage by inflicting heavy losses upon the foes. This is the statue of Major Somnath Sharma, who was the first recipient of the Paramveer Chakra, the highest Indian gallantry award. He was awarded the medal posthumously for his bravery in the Kashmir operations in November 1947. He died while evicting Pakistani infiltrators and raiders from Srinagar airport during the Indo-Pak war of 1947-48 in Kashmir. He belonged to the 4th Kumaon Regiment. On 3rd November 1947, Major Somnath Sharma's company was ordered on a fighting patrol to Badgam village in the Kashmir Valley. A tribal lashkar of 700 raiders approached Badgam from the direction of Gulmarg. The company was soon surrounded by the enemy from three sides and sustained heavy casualties from the ensuing mortar bombardment. Somnath urged his company to fight bravely, often exposing himself to danger as he ran from post to post. When heavy casualties adversely affected the firing power of his company, Major Sharma, with his right hand in plaster, took upon himself the task of filling the magazines and issuing them to men operating light machine guns. While he was busy fighting the enemy, a mortar shell exploded on the ammunition near him. By the time the relief company of 1st Battalion Kumaon Regiment reached Badgam, the position had been overrun. However, the 200 casualties suffered by the enemy made them lose their impetus to advance. The Indian troops in the meantime flew into Srinagar airfield and blocked all routes to Srinagar. In this manner, Somnath Sharma prevented the fall of Srinagar.
Now, you have some time to check your answers. Before you listen to the rest of the audio, look at questions 16 to 20. Listen to the audio and answer the questions.
This is the statue of Lieutenant Colonel Tan Singh Thapa, PVC, who was an Indian Army Major in 1st Battalion, 8th Gorkha Rifles Regiment. At 6 a.m. on 20th October 1962, the Chinese opened a barrage of artillery and mortar fire over Sirijap 1 post near the Chushul airport in Ladakh. The shelling continued till 8:30 and the whole area was set ablaze. Some shells fell on the command post and damaged the wireless set. This put the post out of communication. The Chinese then attacked in overwhelming numbers. Major Thapa and his men repulsed the attack inflicting heavy casualties on enemy, the Chinese mounted another attack in greater numbers after shelling the area with artillery and mortar fire. Major Thapa once again repulsed the attack, inflicting heavy losses on the Chinese. Major Thapa, who was awarded the Paramvir Chakra, was believed to have been killed in this engagement, but he was later discovered to have been taken prisoner. After his release from the prisoner of war camp, he resumed his military career. He retired as Lieutenant Colonel and died in September 2005. Major Thapa's cool courage, conspicuous fighting qualities and leadership were in the highest traditions of our army. This is the statue of Hawaldar Abdul Hamid, who was a soldier in the 4th Battalion, the Grenadiers of the Indian Army. He died in the Khemkaran sector during the Indo-Pak War of 1965. He was the posthumous recipient of the Republic of India's highest military decoration, the Paramvir Chakra. In 1965 Indo-Pak War, Abdul Hamid was posted in the Khemkaran Pickering sector in Punjab. Hawaldar Abdul Hamid's brave action inspired his comrades to put up a gallant fight and to beat back the heavy tank assault by the enemy. This is the statue of Flying Officer Nirmalji Singh Sekhu, PVC, who was an officer of the Indian Air Force. He was posthumously awarded the Paramvir Chakra, India's highest military decoration, in recognition of his lone defense of Srinagar Air Base against a Pakistani air raid during the Indo-Pak War of 1971. The bravery of flying skill and determination displayed by the Flying Officer Sekhu earned him India's highest wartime medal for gallantry, the Paramvir Chakra. His skill was later praised in an article by Salim Beg Mirza, the pilot who shot him down. We must never forget the sacrifices of our brave soldiers. You can have a look at their pictures in the next section, and I'll see you outside the room after 15 minutes.
This is the end of section 2. You have some time to check your answers.
So students, you can check your answers. Go through the questions once again. If there are any blanks, try to guess the answers. And don't leave any question unsolved. Please read all the questions once again. Try to recall the audio. Okay, now let's check the answers.
Here the answer was no more than, question instructions were no more than 3 words as answer. No more than 3 words in the blank to complete the sentences. So answer should be 1 word, 2 words or 3 words, but not more than that. So the first answer is recipients. Recipients means who receive the award. So it was recipients. The second is alert presence. Who is the third one? 13th is Major Somnath Sharma. So it is just Somnath. Mm-hmm. And please go back to the question.
Okay.
So question number 13. This is the statue of Major Somnath. We can't write Major Somnath Sharma because Major and Sharma are already given in the question. So it is just Somnath. You have not to answer Major Somnath Sharma. You have to just answer Somnath. So we go ahead. Answer number 14.
He was awarded the medal posthumously. The posthumously means after death. Here there may be a problem with the spellings, but it's okay. Don't get disheartened. So sometimes there are difficult words, but we want to be exposed to difficult vocabulary also. It's a part of your chapter. And one thing more I want to reinforce, don't think that this chapter you have not done, because it's a test of listening. Jo bhi tusi sun rahe ho, ude accordingly tusi answer dena hai. So this was in the audio posthumously.
Yes, that means after death of the person. He was awarded, because he died in the war, so he was awarded the medal for his bravery in the Kashmir operations. So it is posthumously.
Then next, the Indian troops saved the, what was the answer?
Srinagar airfield. So it is two words, Srinagar airfield. The next is Major Tan Singh Thapa fought the dash was Chinese when he was an Indian Army major. So Chinese was one word. You can write the answers in capital letters or you can write in small letters. That is not a problem because handwriting kharab nahi honi chahiye. The word should be clear so that you get the full marks. The next is Major Thapa, what was the 17th? Is Rifles Regiment. So, again we go back to the question. It was the 8th Gorkha Rifles Regiment. So, 8th Gorkha is already given. So, the answer was Rifles Regiment. The next is Major Thapa repulsed the attack, inflicting heavy losses. What was the answer?
Casualties.
Casualties. Yes, that is casualties means deaths. So, that was the answer for 18th. Then comes the statue of Havaldar Abdul Hamid, who was a soldier in Dash Rifles Regiment. What was the 8th Rifles Regiment? So, next
the
is 4th Battalion. Yes, that was the 19th answer. The 4th Battalion. So, next was about Nirmaljit Singh Sekho. The flying officer Nirmaljit Singh Sekho, PVC, was an officer of the Indian Air Force. Even if you did not listen it carefully, flying officer itself means he is a flyer. He is a flying officer. He is in the Air Force. So, even if you didn't get the answer, you can guess. Yeah. Make a guess that flying wala banda hai ga, wo Air Force da hona chahiye.
So that's why we told ki agar thoda koi answer miss ho janda hai, to context dekho. According to context, guess kar do. Zyada to zyada, it will be wrong. It's
because
okay.
This award, this is Paramveer Chakra, it's the highest award of bravery in our country. So it can be given to army person, a navy person, or an air force person. Army, jedi hegi hai, o fauj hogi. Then air force, jedi hai, o hawai fauj. Then pani wali fauj jedi hegi hai, that is navy. So it was given to a person of very high bravery, and it is the highest award in the country. Param means highest, very important. Veer, veerta to hai, ki bravery hai. And then this is the chakra, it is the award given to people who are very brave.
So now you can total your marks. Dekho ki 20 jo kitne marks aaye hain. Don't get disheartened if you didn't get good marks, because listening is all about practice. If you are not able to get marks, that means you were not able to understand the words. So what to do? How to improve the marks? Routine life de vich, you must listen to English. Make it a part of your routine that you should at least listen to English news for at least 10 minutes daily, or listen to any audio on your phones. All of you have smartphones these days, technology driven bachche ho tusi. So listen to audios, good audios in English with good accent. It's all about practice of the ears. Sade ears nu English sunan di aadat na hon karke, we are not able to understand, we are not able to comprehend what is being said. So is tarah de test assi itho conduct karde rahange, aur apa ide vich marks improve tahi kar sakde ha if you practice it at home also.
And eh sari cheezan nu reinforce kardi hai ki thodi reading. if you are reading properly, you have to read. Dono jede hai gaya input skills hai. If you don't know the spellings of the what is being spoken, jeda tusi sun rahe ho, ode tonu spellings nahi aunde, tonu oda meaning nahi pata. Tad tusi jedo read karoge question paper, you will not get to know the answers. So what is more very important is ki thonu jehdi hai synonyms aune chahide hai, words de different meanings aune chahide hai, phir us da jehda hega hai kis context de vich use hunda hai oh sanu pata lagna chahide hai. Only then we will be able to listen and write the answers carefully. So jehdi listening hai and reading, eh dono overlap kardiyan, ik dusre nu eh reinforce kardiyan. ਜਿੰਨਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਪੜਾਂਗੇ ਔਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਸੁਣਾਂਗੇ ਤਾਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਹੈ ਐਕਚੁਅਲ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਸਾਡੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਆਊਟਪੁੱਟ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਹੈ ਸਪੀਕਿੰਗ ਦੀ ਜਾਂ ਰਾਈਟਿੰਗ ਦੀ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਫਾਰਮ ਹੋ ਸਕੂਗੀ ਅੱਛੇ ਮਾਰਕਸ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਆਉਣਗੇ ਅਗਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੈ ਰੀਡਿੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਲਿਸਨਿੰਗ ਪ੍ਰੋਪਰ ਸਾਡੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਹੈ
ਸੋ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਦਾ ਐਂਡ ਆਫ ਟੂਡੇਜ਼ ਲਿਸਨਿੰਗ ਟੈਸਟ We'll continue with the next two sections in the next listening class. So, it's Varinder Sekho and Anurag Sidhu. Our phone numbers are there. You can talk to us. You can discuss anything with us related to these lectures. And please, teachers and students, please send your feedbacks at this address. Please note it down. assistantdirectoraffiliation@gmail.com. Your inputs, your feedback will help us in further improving this program. So we hope to achieve we have great targets. We have focused on that all our students will be able to, at the end of the session, the students will be able to get 20 out of 20 in such tests. So hoping for the best.
We are also going to, for teachers, we'll also be sending this text in the WhatsApp group. You can take the test from there
for and practice.
For practice, otherwise this is going to be going to be repeated in the next class also. So you can go and have a look at that again. The teacher can get any help they want from. Yeah. We've already given the numbers.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you so much.